Hey YouTube, it's Gibby back again with another pickups and trades. This is going to be for the month of December. I know it's a little bit late, but work's kind of had me hammered here for a little while and some other things, so apologize for not having many videos up. And I'm a little bit behind on a lot of my favorite channels out there, catching up on y'all's videos. But hopefully I'll be get caught up a little bit here in the next week or two. And work slows down a bit and lets me get back into playing some games and doing some videos and stuff like that. I've got a few videos already in the works. I just haven't wrapped them up yet. I've got a PlayStation 1 gameplay review as requested by Tyler, PS1 collector forever. He'd been asking me for a while to do a PS1 game, so I picked one out that I'll be uploading soon, and then also get back to doing some random retro stuff and some stuff like that. I really haven't had a lot of time to play a lot of the retro games like I usually do. Like I said, with the holidays that come up, and then work right after the holidays, it's had me slammed. So, and then also everything that, you know, the kids got for Christmas, they've kind of been, we've been playing a lot of those games with them. So that's another reason I haven't had many chances to get some videos up. So hopefully I'll get back in the swing of playing my retro stuff and some of the other things I can do some videos on for you guys. And so yeah, this is going to be December pickups. I've got all my January stuff together too. I had to shoot that video in a few weeks. But I'm also in the process of rearranging my retro game room, so I'll probably do an updated video on that in a month or two of after I get everything situated how I want it. Just doing a lot of reorganizing in there and stuff. So go ahead and jump into the games I got in December. And like always, I'm on show everything. I'll just leave some of the junk for the overview shot at the end and just show you a good portion of it. And I'll start off with the stuff I traded for, either with some, you know, YouTubers or and some trades I did on Guzex and stuff, and then I'll jump into stuff that I bought. One of the things I got, I don't have it in here with me, but it was I got an iPod Touch. We got that for Christmas and been using that a lot. Of course, I already had a Zune, but the iPod Touch is pretty incredible. And I want to thank mp4podcast.com, his channel, for his messages for putting me on to a lot of sales back around Christmas time. I got a lot of great games for that, for the iPod. Still, to me, I'm not big on handhelds. I like the PSP a lot, and a little bit with the, you know, I'll play the Game Boy Advance SP and stuff like that a little bit. I play them in pretty short spurts because of the small screens. I prefer to play on big TV and stuff. So thank him for that. I'll jump in and show you the stuff I got for some YouTubers. And the first thing was a trade with great guy, SystemSyko. I'm sure many of you know his channel. The dude's got crazy collection of games, and he collects a lot of other stuff like kicks and hats and stuff like that. I don't know how he collects so much stuff. He's even got vinyl records and everything. You know, I have a hard enough time with just games, and this dude, he just collects so much stuff. It amazes me sometimes, but really cool guy, and he did a trade with me. And I'll put links to all these people down in the description as well. And he sent me Deep Fighter for Dreamcast. I didn't have that game. Never played it. I'll be checking that one out. And he also traded me Shinobi 2 for the Game Gear. I did put this one in a little bit when I first got it, just to try it out, because I hadn't played my Game Gear in a long time. So it's a cool game. I'll be playing it a lot more. So thank you, SystemSyko. Also, Bracey, known as Retro Snow or SnowCon 3 here on YouTube, he sent me a game for Christmas, and it's one I'd had on my want list on my website for years and years. I'd never owned this game, and I'd always wanted it, and it's Golden Axe, the Duel for the Saturn. It was a really nice surprise to get that in the mail, so haven't got to play it yet. Hopefully me and the boy, my oldest son, will pop it in there and give it a try. I'm sure I'll love it, because I'm a big fan of the Golden Axe series on the So, thank you, Bracey. Also, this wasn't a trade or anything, but I'm sure some of you have watched the EMU review with Jason Heine. He's got a channel here, and he's also, you know, on the All Gen Gamers podcast. But anyway, he had a video up where he was selling Christmas album. And I'm a big fan of Christmas albums, and he had a link there, you know, you could buy it digitally, and I just sent him a message. I was like, hey, man, do you have physical copies of the album? I'd like to go ahead and buy your CD. And he said, yeah, sure, and I went ahead and bought that from him. He sent it to me. And I had it in heavy rotation with, of course, Dave Anderson's Christmas album and then several other ones that we have always in our carousel. And really good album, both of these. And it's amazing, you know, some of these people on YouTube. It's cool to find out what kind of talents they have besides, you know, button mashing, you know, with a joystick. And both these guys are really talented musicians. These were great albums, and when I mentioned about this, he said, "Have you heard my other stuff?" And I hadn't. And he has another channel that has like some previews of his music. So I checked it out and ended up buying the three albums that he made. And I really recommend you guys checking out his music channel. Get little samples, maybe, you know, help him out, buy some records. They're really good stuff. Here's his first album here. I played it for about a week or so in the car. It's a little heavy towards the rap, and it's not bad. It's a good album. But the second album I've had in there for a few weeks, it's out in my car. I actually don't have that one in here. I've got the first and the third. The second album I've been listening to for a solid 2 weeks now, and it's really good. I'm really enjoying that. It's a little more variety to it. I mean, it's got some, you know, some rap, and it sounds, you know, almost pop, or some of the songs are almost pop or slower. You know, he slows it down a bit. He's got a good variety there with rap and pop and even like a club sound almost. And, you know, I'm really digging that album a lot. So I actually haven't opened the third one yet. I'm going to wait till I'm, you know, a little wore out on the second one before I take this one out of the car and pop it in. But, yeah, Jason Heine. I'm going to put links to both his channels in there. I'm sure a lot of you have seen his video game channel, but probably if you're like me, I had no idea he had a music channel and even had records. So go give him a listen and probably enjoy some of his music and maybe buy some of his albums. So I thank him for that. He gave me a real good deal too on his albums. Gave me a good package deal on that. So thank you, Jason. And that's it for the YouTube community stuff that I got. And I'll show you some stuff I got off Guzex, which if any of you don't know, it's a trading site where you can trade in some of your games for points and use them points to buy games from other members on there, which is really cool. Unless you're really, you know, OCD about your stuff being perfect or not getting greatest hit stuff, because a lot of times it's hit or miss. You'll get some really mint games, and then you'll get some games that are a little roughed up. But for me, I just want the games, if they work, they work. That's great. And that's all I really care about. So when I get the other stuff, it's just a nice bonus. But anyway, I'll start with some of the older stuff and show you what I got. I got Mortal Kombat Deadly Alliance for Game Boy Advance. Got two great Game Boy games. I got Kirby's Dream Land 2 and Operation C. Genesis game, I picked up Three Ninjas Kickback. Never played that. A few 64 games. Monopoly. Nothing too spectacular, but I'm trying to get a 64 collection, trying to get them all. So any carts that I can get that I didn't have, I go ahead and request them. And I got Aero Fighters Assault, Mace the Dark Age, San Francisco Rush, the Extreme Racing game. Love that series. Spider-Man and Fighter's Destiny. Some PS1 games I got off of Guzex. Finally picked up Final Fantasy Tactics again. I'm glad to have that back in the collection. Even though it's Greatest Hits version, it was like Gem Mint, so that was good. Gran Turismo 2. The Lost World Jurassic Park. Frogger 2. Stuart Little 2. Bakugi. And Golden Tee Golf, one of the greatest arcade golf games, in my opinion, ever. And then I got a long box of Doom, which was a nice surprise. I figured I'd get a different version than that, and this thing is just perfect mint, like it's brand new. So that was a really, really cool trade there. Sega CD game I picked up on Guzex, Trivial Pursuit. Some other games are going there. Quake 3 Arena, one of my favorites of the Quake series. And this one was still sealed, so that was really cool. Phantasy Star Online. PSP game, I got Pinball Hall of Fame. some PS2s. I picked up Battlestar Galactica, Phantasy Star Universe, Lupin the Third, Deck of Sports for the Wii, Okuna for the Wii. This was also came sealed. It was pretty cool when you get trades from people on there expecting just, you know, maybe even a rental copy or something. You never know. And then you end up getting a sealed game. And that's a really nice surprise. And then I got Ghost Recon 2 for 360 here. So that was all my trades for the month. Now I'll show you a lot of purchases I got. I picked up a large lot of Genesis games for my son for his retro gen that I got him for Christmas, just so he'd have a bunch of cards to play. And there's three doubles in there that I actually didn't have in my collection, so I just scooped them up and took them. So there's Stargate, Williams Greatest Hits, and Flashback. Then I picked this 32X game up on eBay, paid $5 for it. It's the WWF arcade game. It was one of the few ones I'm still missing. I'm still missing Pitfall and, of course, the Spider-Man to finish my U.S. set on that. So it's one step closer with that. And two of the games I'm most excited to pick up that I picked up that in December was this game I've been wanting to get back in my collection for a long, long time when I lost my Sega CD collection. You know, I've regretted it ever since, but this, I picked this one up and I got it for a really good deal. And it's like brand new condition. It's got a very small crack in the case there, but everything inside of it is like it just was open. It's brand new. Lunar Silver Star. This is one of my favorite games on the Sega CD, and I'm going to be probably popping that in and playing through it again before too long. But yeah, that's a great, great game to have back. And then I also picked up this, Die Hard Arcade. I've been looking for this for a long, long time. I played that in the arcades a long time ago. And I've always loved this game. I always wanted to own it for Saturn, but I just never, you know, jumped in and spent the money. I actually got two good deals. I bought this game and it on a buy it now auction, disc only, for $10. And it came, and the disc was really bad shape and it didn't work. And you could actually hold up the light and you could see where the surface was scratched so bad you could see through it. So I emailed the seller and he just refunded my money. He didn't ask no questions or nothing like that. So I was pretty bummed out. And then like a week later, this popped up for buy it now for $10. And it was a complete, and it's in perfect shape, great shape. So I was really ecstatic to get this like that. Usually this game goes for a lot more than $10, especially a complete version. So yeah, that's good to get in the collection, Die Hard Arcade. Also imported a large lot of Japanese Saturn games. I picked up about 30 titles. Some of them were games I already own the U.S. versions of. Some of them were some strategy RPGs that I'll probably never be able to play because of the language barrier. But there is some of them in here that I was glad to get, and the main reason I grabbed them, and I got them for $1 apiece, so I couldn't argue with it, even getting some of the games I couldn't even play. And like I said, I did a best offer. It was 30 of them, and I best offered it for $30, and he took it, so really awesome. There was no artwork or anything like that, but the discs are all like mint condition, so I was really excited. And I can just print off artwork and that's no problem. But I got Saturn Bomberman. I'm just going to show you a handful of them. I'm not going to show you them all because, like I said, some of them are just RPGs or SRPGs and stuff like that. So Fighting Vipers, Gale Racer. Retro Snow did a really good review on that if you want to check that out. Enemy Zero, Shining the Holy Ark, X-Men Children of the Atom, another Lunar game, the Silver Star Story Complete, Virtua Fighter 2, Sega Rally Championship. I'm probably going to butcher this name, but it's Hizatsu, and it's actually a really cool little action platformer. I was actually surprised at that. And Virtuon, Cyber Troopers. So that's some of the import ones I got. Alright, some other stuff I picked up. I found this at the pawn shop. I was really surprised to find this. The Metal Gear Solid 3 Subsistence. And it's because usually if you find this game, it's missing the second disc with the Metal Gear 1 and 2 from the MSX system, which I'm amazed I found it in here. It was $7. It didn't have the manual, but I didn't care. It had both discs. So I'm really looking forward to playing those two games. I've never played, you know, the first two original Metal Gears. So yeah, $7. And then, you know, for Christmas, I always get either games or gift certificates most of the time from a lot of my friends and family. So a lot of those were GameStop gift cards. So I took advantage of that. They had some buy two, get one free sales. And I did some of them online and some of them in the store. And I picked up some really good titles. I got two GameCube games. One of them was the Sonic Gems Collection, which got a lot of really cool stuff on it. And I picked up Worms 3D. And the PS2 games, I ended up getting a lot of SNK stuff again. And then some other titles I'd been looking for a little while. Spy Hunter Nowhere to Run. SNK Arcade Classics. Shining Force Neo. And Television Lives. Got the Art of Fighting Anthology. Got Samurai Legend Musashi. And this is Way of the Samurai 2. I had to print out a cover art for that. Got Green Lantern Heritage of War. Monster Rancher EVO. Samurai Jack. My son actually saw that one, liked it, so I grabbed it. Klonoa 2. Gauntlet Dark Legacy. Fatal Fury Battle Archives 2. I got Volume 1, you know, the month before that. So now I got both those. R-Type Final. Mr. Mosquito. King of Fighters Impact. Then some other stuff that I bought new. Got the Super Scribblenauts. Great game, great series. Marker Man Adventures, I got that for my son, but he didn't really like it too much, and I played a little bit, and it's kind of meh. I don't know, it's not as good as I expected it to be. We also got the Rock Band 3 keyboard bundle. Picked it up. Got Left 4 Dead 2. That's the PS3 games I picked up. I got Quantum Theory. Got that from Gamefly, really cheap. Rock of the Dead. We've actually been playing this some this week. It's okay. It's not a bad game. It reminds me a lot of the Typing of the Dead and stuff like that. I thought it would be a little bit better than it is, but I don't know. It was a pretty cheap title. We got it for less than $20. So getting a little bit of fun out of it. It was pretty cool. I picked up Enslaved because I've seen so many people with videos on this. So I want to give this a try. It looks like it's a really great game. Got Resonance of Fate. Picked that one up really cheap. And Time Crisis Raging Storm. Go with the move controllers that I'd picked up. Played a little bit of it so far, and it seems like it's going to be pretty good fun. I've always liked rail shooters, so. And I seen this actually on Happy Console Gamer. On his last pickups, he had picked this up, and I didn't even know they had released the Blu-ray yet, which kind of odd for me because I follow the Transformers and G.I. Joe stuff. I've been a big nut of those series since G1. And so I'm glad to have that. Just be cool to see how the Blu-ray conversion went. Also got what, you know, just about everybody got on YouTube was the Super Mario All-Stars. Pre-ordered it, you know, a long time ago, so it was great to get that game. Like everybody else, I was disappointed they didn't put Super Mario World, but, you know, if they had done 25th anniversary and only had Mario 1 in here, I'd still bother. It's just as being a big fan of the series and so much memories with Mario, you know, I'd have bought it anyway, so glad to have that. I got Metroid Other M. Haven't started that yet. Looking forward to playing that some. And then Sin and Punishment. That's it for the new games. Oh, also, My brother-in-law had found a Atari game. He got me River Raid 2. I've been looking for that game for a long time as well. So I was glad he found that and gave it to me. Brought that to me for Christmas too. And also, my Halo 360, you know, had been having some laser problems, and it was only reading, you know, about half the games, which was kind of annoying. So my other brother-in-law, he was like, "Hey man, I got my 360 still boxed up. I haven't hardly played it. I ain't playing it anymore. It's been sitting there in the closet for months." So he sold me his Elite for $100. So that was cool. I just boxed up my Halo 3 Collector's Edition, put it away, and now I've been playing, you know, all the games I want to play on this one. So it's good to have a fully working, functional 360 again. And lastly, I'll show you a poster my sister had gotten for me. She found a cool Halo Reach poster. It's a horizontal poster, which is really neat, because you get so many of the tall ones, it's nice to get the, I don't know if you can see a good shot of it or not, but I thought it was a really cool poster, and it was nice of her to pick it up and bring it to me. So yeah, that's it for December pickups. Like I said, I'll be having some more videos out soon. Different stuff. You know, reviews and gameplay and of course the January pickups before too long. Go check out all the guys I mentioned in the video. Jason Heine, Dave Anderson, check out their music. They got some good stuff. Thanks a lot, all new subscribers and everybody, you know, that's always commenting on my pages and videos and stuff. I really appreciate the support and everything. Really enjoying YouTube and all the new friends and channels and stuff that I've found since I've joined. So keep up the great videos, everybody. I'm trying to keep up with y'all's. Whenever I get time, I'm trying to catch everything I can. And you guys got some really great stuff. So thanks for watching, and take it easy.
There's actually three really good Super Nintendo games I forgot to mention I picked up.